And the search for McDowell has people in the area on edge and wondering how they stay safe with this guy still out there somewhere. On your side's Don White is live in Callahan with some safety tips and how people in the area are feeling tonight.
Almost 100 police vehicles are here on both sides of the command center here at the First Baptist Church of Callahan, and their presence continues to grow here each day as they become more and more determined to catch the suspects.
Your adrenaline is up. You are very wary of your surroundings. You're constantly listening. It's stressful at times. You can't. At first, you couldn't get out of your home.
Alan Mons lives in the middle of the search area. Dozens of law enforcement agencies from Florida and Georgia have joined the manhunt for Patrick McDowell. A whole busload of officers arrived this afternoon.
This isn't the first and it won't be the last.
First Coast News crime and safety expert Mark Bachman says people who live in the area can take steps to stay safe, such as making sure their windows and doors are locked.
If you can light up the area outside with floodlights or whatever, I would do that. If they're out buildings that you fear that somebody could gotten into and there's no way to secure them, there's plenty of law enforcement up there now, more today than ever, that can, if you call them, I'm sure they will clear that building, as they should.
The reward is up to $54,000 for information leading to the capture of Patrick McDowell. Coming up at 6, I'll have more on what Bachman says you should not do if you live in this area. In Callahan, Dawn White, First Coast News, on your side.